stupid little place.
Yes, they've done wonders with it. You know, this used to be one of the most swampy, disease-infested areas of the whole jungle. And they've turned it into this smashing little restaurant. You are, Kwame. Thank you. Hello, Mr. Quay-Quay.
Hello there, Mr. Spare Buttons applied with his shirt. Nice to see you.
These are some of my fellow explorers, Sir Charles Farquharson, Brian Bailey, Betty Bailey, and this is Mr. Quay-Quay, who started the whole place.
It really is super.
Oh, terrific idea.
Thank you. May I recommend the alligator fury? Now then, have you decided?
Yes, well, there's two avocado vinaigrette here, and what are you going to have, Brian?
Quiche Lorraine for me, please.
Right, so that's two avocado, one quiche. So, that's two avocado, one quiche.
And the soup of the day.
Right. And to follow.
Two chicken a la reine, please, with sauce provençal.
And one scampi désiré.
And a bœuf bourguignon with a green salad.
Right on. Two chicken, one scampi, one bœuf with a green salad. There may be a little delay.
That's fine, but we have to be out by three.
Yes, sir, yes. We try.
BBC would like to announce that the next scene is not considered suitable for family viewing. It contains scenes of violence involving people's heads and arms getting chopped off, their ears nailed to trees, and their toenails pulled out in slow motion. There are also scenes of naked women with floppy breasts. And also, at one point, you can see a pair of buttocks. And there's another bit where I'll swear you can see everything. But my friend says it's just the way he's holding the spear. Because of the unsuitability of the scene, the BBC will be replacing it with a scene from a repeat of Gardening Club for 1958. Back to the story.
It was a nasty business back at the restaurant.
Yes, I thought most places took party cards nowadays.
Yeah. Where do you think they're taking us, Brian?
God knows.
Look! The sacred volcano Andu, which no man has seen before.
No, next to that. No, next to that.
The forbidden plateau of Roraima, the lost world, thrown up by mighty earth movements thousands of millions of years ago, where strange primeval creatures define evolution, lurk in the dark impenetrable forests, cut off forever from the outside world.
I still can't see it.
I don't think that's where they're taking us.
Yes, and God knows what we'll find there.
What page, please?
What?
What page in the script? Come on, you dogs, we have far to go. We must lose no time. Come on, you dogs, we have far to go. We must lose no time. Come on, you dogs. Come on, you dogs, we have time to lose. This has gone too far.
Meanwhile, back in London, at the British Explorers Club in the Mall.
Any news of Betty Bailey's expedition, Hargreaves?
Page
9.
Oh, thank you.
The Lost World of Roy Rama.
That's my line.
Oh, sorry. Where were they going, sir?
The Lost World of Roy Rama.
Yes, sir. We've got a telegram.
Oh.
Reads it. Expedition superb, weather excellent, everything wonderful.
I wonder what's gone wrong.
For God's sake, be careful.
Wait a minute. I'm going to go after them.
Oh, for God's sake, be careful, sir. For God's sake.
God, Betty, we're done for.
We'll never get out of here. We're completely lost. Lost! Even the natives have gone. Goodbye, Betty. Goodbye, Ferguson. Goodbye, Brian.
It's been a great expedition. Great expedition.
All that will be left of us is a map, a compass, and a few feet of film recording our last moments.
Wait a minute.
What is it?
If we're on film, there must be someone filming us.
My God, Betty! You're right!
Look! Hello!
Great to see you!
Hello. Super to see you!
See you!
Wait a minute!
What is it again?
If this is the crew who were filming us, who's filming us now? Look!
Good there, man. Good there.
No. No good. How are we going to get that feeling of personal alienation of self from society with this load of bulldog Drummond crap? When I was doing La Notte with that Monica Vitti gal, she didn't give me none of this Empire Building shit, man.
Not so fast, Takarumba. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Inspector Baboon of Scotland Yard, Special Court Film Director Squad, Jungle Division.
Baboon of a yacht!
Shut up! Right, Takarumba. I'm arresting you for impersonating Signor Michelangelo Antonioni, an Italian film director who co-strips all his own films, largely jettisoning narrative in favour of vague incident and relentless character study. In his first film, Cunarca di un amore, 1950, the couple are brought together by a shared irrational guilt. L'Amice followed in 1955, and 1959 saw the first of Antonioni's world-famous trilogy, L'Avventura, an acute study of boredom, restlessness, and the futilities and agonies of purposeless living. In Les Clichés, 3 years later, this analysis of the sentiments was taken up once again. We do not have to know each other to love, says the heroine, and perhaps we do not have to love. The eclipse of the emotions only casts its shadows when darkness descends. Signor Antonioni first makes use of colour to underline the...